Hey guys, this is David Kwan. I'm here to talk about my favorite character from Mass Effect Trilogy, all three games included. So I talked a lot about Mass Effect 3, Mass Effect 2. I talked a great deal of length about my favorite character from Mass Effect 1. That's probably the longest video I've ever done in this series of videos. But yeah, talking about the whole trilogy as a whole, it's a hard pick between two characters, and I mean, I've already revealed who my favorite character is, and is that's Liara Sassoni. The other alternate for me that was really, you know, it's like neck and neck for me, you know, picking Liara over this character, and it's really Commander Shepard. I really want to pick Commander Shepard because it's, you play as this character, but it's one character that you become so attached to. It's a character that you carry through three different games, and whatever decisions you make, you see that, you know, you see this character evolve and change along with those decisions that you make for your character. And the character has a distinct personality, whatever decisions you make for it. And it's really awesome that BioWare allowed you to pick a male character or female character, and they're voiced by two different voice actors. It's an incredible thing to do, to have done. Some people, you know, it's a big investment risk, you know, because, you know, a lot of players might just have picked the male character and played through the whole three games that way, or might have just picked the female character and played through the whole games that way, in which case one person's voice acting talent is never witnessed by that player. So it's that kind of investment risk there, and I'm really glad that they did it, because you have a player like me who played all three Mass Effect games with both male and female character. So I've witnessed, you know, the male voice acting and Jennifer Hill's voice acting in all three games. And the way that the characters portray themselves. It's interesting, whenever I pick the male character, I think Mass Effect 1, I picked the male character first. Mass Effect 2, I believe I went with the female character for Mass Effect 2 in my first playthrough. For some reason, I decided to kind of... Oh no, I continued on... Crap, my memory is really bad. But anyway... The point I wanted to make was, whenever I picked a male character for Shepard, it was always black or really darker skinned character. I don't know why I did that, but he looks so badass. My character just looks so badass. And he has that scar. And then in Mass Effect 2, when I make him be a renegade character, he has that like red things like, you know, coming over. He looks like such a badass. It's amazing. So I always make him black, which is really interesting. And I feel like, you know, his voice acting doesn't quite match like a black character, but it works. I think it works. And for some reason, whenever I pick a female character in Mass Effect, it's always white, red-haired female woman. I don't know why I did that all the time, but like it to me, it makes sense that it's like red-haired female character for me. And as I've said in the previous video, I much prefer being the female character, even though I, you know, my initial impulse when I started Mass Effect was starting a Mass, you know, I think I spent more time on Mass Effect as a male Shepard than the female Shepard. That's probably true, but I'm more personally attached to the female Commander Shepard, simply because it's just to me, it makes her seem more human, and there's much more variation in her voice acting and in her characterization to me. But that's my personal opinion. I know a lot of people think that Jennifer Hale's voice acting is not up to her usual, you know, standard of awesome voice acting talent in some Mass Effect games. I think Mass Effect 3 was probably her weakest. Although it's not too much different from Mass Effect 2, I want to say. So yeah, Shepard's definitely one of those characters that I want to pick. I can't Mass Effect is a universe where you really become so attached to this character, and you see this character evolve throughout this whole console generation. For 7 years or so, you make decisions with this character, and those decisions carry over for 2 more games, which is an incredible thing. But my favorite character from the whole trilogy is Lyra Sissoni. Because as a trilogy, I think she really grew on me. The first time she appeared, I thought she was interesting. There's not much known, you know, that revealed about her in the first game, other than she is a character that Shepard finds kind of trapped in this planet. Shepard rescues her. She has a very nerdy personality. She's kind of aloof, and she doesn't really talk all that much. And you know, one of my a YouTuber who views my videos, especially about Mass Effect, N7 Normandy One, he made this comment in one of these videos, and he said that Lyra's personality and character really changes from game to game to game. It's like by the time we reach Mass Effect 3, it's almost like she's become a different person. I kind of actually, you know, I think that's a really a strong point. And I really kind of agree with that. She really does become a completely different kind of person. At first, it's kind of like, you know, she's just kind of trying to fit in. But then by the end of Mass Effect 2, I want to say, she has become much more defined personality. She's more confident and bold, and she knows what she wants to do, and she's going to do it. And she will fight for what she believes in, even if it goes against everything else, even if it goes against what Commander Shepard wants to do. She's very loyal to Commander Shepard, but yet she's very idealistic, and she has this sense of how things should be, and how things should be fair and whatnot. The downloadable content in which she first meets, what was his name, but the Protean character, the DLC character, when she first meets him, and is so disturbed by learning about Proteans, because it's totally different from what she imagined from Proteans, and just seeing this contrast of this Protean who believes in absolute control and authoritarian government, and Lyra the Asari, who thinks, you know, who's very idealistic and thinks that, you know, we should striving to have the best knowledge, the best understanding of everything out there, and always being curious and always being skeptical and believing in the power of democracy. These two characters meet, and it's just, Lyra is just taken aback. She's just horrified of what she learns, the truth about Protheans. That was a really powerful thing. I think that those moments made just that DLC worth it. Although the Protean character himself was pretty cool and interesting, but to me, seeing Lyra's reaction to that Protean character was all the more worth it. But yeah, seeing her really change and evolve and struggle with herself, and then becoming the Shadow Broker and the aftermath of becoming the Shadow Broker, that this total change in character, this total growth as a character, was what really interested me about Lyra, and her idealistic nature was also what kind of made me really, I think it helps that I'm, you know, a straight guy, so like it makes me have a great kind of attachment to it. By Mass Effect 3, I had my male and female character romance Lyra, because how could I not? Like, she's, if I was Commander Shepard and I had to pick someone to have romance with, it would definitely be Lyra. And my second pick, of course, would be Tali, but that's a very complicated sexual relationship because of her suit and stuff, and Shepard being human. But yeah, Lyra is to me a very lovable character. It's very idealistic and headstrong. She really embodies that type of strong independence that I really like seeing in female characters, and Lyra is that, which is why I like her so much, and I so liked watching her develop as this powerful character at the end, but still with incredibly, you know, she has a way to become, she's so idealistic that she can be very hurt, when the truth just comes to her. And she can have moments of doubt that makes her seem, you know, really weak, but it's totally understandable, and it's totally relatable. So that's really it. This is probably my last video in regards to characters about Mass Effect. I still have yet to... I keep telling myself that I'm going to do these videos, but I haven't yet. But they'll be coming, in the videos in which I just share my thoughts on Mass Effect 2 and the game, and share my thoughts on Mass Effect 3, the game as a whole, and not just about the characters or the story. And of course, there's this other video series I'm doing that I've kind of had to put on hiatus for a while. But actually, I think I only made one video on that series, and I kind of stopped. But the video series in which I talk about how games tell their stories. And Mass Effect is definitely going to be in there, because the way the storytelling in Mass Effect is very unique in this industry. So definitely more Mass Effect to talk about in future videos. But as far as characters go, this is the last one. This was a female character, and so I'm still going to try to abide by the rules, my own rules. So in the next video, the next character that I'm talking about will be a male character. As long as it's not, you know, a robotic character. I still haven't decided which game I want to do for the next video, so I'll keep you guys in suspense. I don't know what question to ask you guys, to leave you to comment. I don't know. Just comment anything if you want. If you liked the video, if you didn't like the video, any suggestions, questions, whatever you want to say, you know, I encourage you to leave a comment. You know me to always respond to comments, unless you don't like that. And, you know, if you don't like me responding to you, just put don't reply, which is fine. If you just want to say something and leave it, that's totally fine. But yeah, that's it for this video. Next video, I honestly don't know what game I'm going to talk about, but stay tuned.